Well, joining us is the eighth announced signing of the year for the Dundee Stars. It is Josh Britton. Josh, firstly, how excited were you to finally tell everyone that you had signed for the Dundee Stars this past weekend?
Yeah, it's been an amazing time. Been an amazing weekend. I'm super excited to get over to Dundee and get started for this season. Meet all the fans, see all the beautiful sites, the culture. It's going to be exciting.
And of course, everyone is well familiar of your time at the Cardiff Devils last year. I think it was 67 games, we've noted, I think, that you played last year for them, and also picked up that Continental Cup bronze medal. But how would you sum up your season in the Elite League and that one with the Cardiff Devils?
Yeah, it was amazing. They're a top notch organization. I love my time there. The fans there are great and amazing. But having said that, I think we came up a little short in our expectations, and it was great for me to get to know the league, learn the players in the league, know what to expect. And now coming into this season, I'm fully prepared, feeling the best that I've ever felt, and I'm ready to have a lot of success with the Dundee Stars.
Yeah, was that a tougher year than you thought it would be in the Elite League coming into that first season?
I don't really think people understand how good the league has gotten. It is really great hockey. It's definitely a North American style game. And you factor in the bigger ice. There's a lot of talent now coming into this league, and the hockey's fast, and the schedule is something too you don't factor in. You play a lot of games. It's 67, like you said, and that was all the way to finals weekend. So yeah, it's great. I love the league. I'm really excited to get back over there and really excited to get the season started.
Of course, you did pick up that bronze medal. What was that like at that point in the season? Was that what did that achievement feel like as part of the roster?
Yeah, it was great. I mean, to be honest with you, you always want to win gold. So, that experience coming up a little short is never fun. Even in the finals this year, it's coming so close, it's never a great feeling. But you leave those type of games feeling motivated to come back and try and do it all again and actually surpass it and win it and lift the trophy. So
yeah, we could talk about that playoff weekend, I suppose, a little bit. Does it still sting that you weren't able to get the job done last year, Josh, if there's any Cardiff Devils fans watching?
It stung in the moment, but now looking back, I mean, there's just so many factors, and everyone did really give it their all. They put it all out there, so you can't be mad about that. Sometimes it bounces your way in professional sports, sometimes it doesn't, and with 6 minutes left, it's just one of those things. So in the moment it stings, but right now it's learning from that moment and growing from those type of challenges and then moving forward and moving it and motivating it you for success.
And of course, even when the news was announced of you signing at the Stars on the weekend, I noticed there was still a host of Cardiff Devils messages from their fans who were wishing you well, sad not to see you back. And I suppose that talks of what their fan base has been like to you last year.
Yeah, the fan base is incredible there. And, they give you their support every single night. I think we had the highest attendance last year consistently. So that's always appreciated. And we always appreciate the love and support. And, on that note, too, I know the Dundee fans are also super passionate. And I remember playing there and, the fans really getting into it. It's an intimate arena, so you can hear everybody in the stands. And, that passion doesn't go unnoticed. So I hope that carries over into this season. And I'm really excited to get to meet all the fans here in Dundee and get things going.
Yeah, a slightly, I suppose, a season to forget for Stars fans last year. But even you'll have noticed that when you came in those latter games, those crowds were still supporting the Stars thick and thin, regardless of where the position they were in the league was or anything that was happening, which is as a credit to them. But I suppose they'll want to know now, moving to Dundee Stars, how on earth did this move come about? And what did Mark Lefebvre say to you that got you to commit to the Stars for this season? Because no doubt there was offers elsewhere as well.
Yeah, absolutely. I had a really good chat with Mark, and I immediately got a great first impression. He's a 10 out of 10 human being. And great guy. I can't wait to meet him. And also, you know, you look at last year, the Guildford Flames, you know, they were last in the season the year before, and they come in and they shocked the whole league by staying at the top of the league for an extended period of time. And they were a contending team. And I think, you know, the feeling that I got from Mark in our phone conversation is he's really going to put together a solid roster and give the Dundee Stars a real chance, you know, to compete this year. So for me, it was an easy decision. The fans, the arena, the beautiful location. I mean, Scotland is just stunning. I can't wait to get there and explore with my wife. So I'm really excited to get this started. And it was a fairly easy decision.
Is that one of the things that impressed you, was Mark's hunger on that call, Josh? Where I know right away from talking to you, you've been mentioning you want to win championships. I presume going and getting yourself into the position of like a Guildford Flames did last season, or at least into those playoff finals where you can, you know, really kick on and have a chance of winning something with the Stars is where you seem to be going. And is that the vision of Mark when you've been speaking to him as well?
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. You know, like our goal this year is to win. And if you're not playing with that expectation of yourself, then, you know, in my opinion, why are you out there? So the goal here this season is to win. And, you know, I want to do everything in my power throughout the lineup to try and help that. So
you touched on as well your time in the Elite League last year and how it was that learning process and perhaps it being an even better league than you maybe anticipated before you joined, and tougher. How would you assess your season last year personally then? And then what are you hoping to bring this year that maybe you didn't last year?
Yeah, well, I think, you know, if you look at the Cardiff lineup, I mean, they're so deep and they have so many great players. So for me, you know, being a second, third line guy, a guy who can chip in offensively, but also, you know, really take pride in the defensive zone and the little things of the game that are so important, the little details that, you know, need to be done every single night and those habits that need to be established every night to consistently win. So, you know, I think this year I'm hoping to be relied on more offensively. You know, I'm a big winger with size. You know, I like to play aggressive, intimidate the other team, but also, you know, have some skill and some finesse. And I think I'm really, really primed to have a great season this year. And I can't wait to meet Mark, the team, the staff, and the fans, and really give it my best effort this year to win.
And this year in a Stars jersey, you'll probably play your 1,000th match. Do you think that that experience you've got is going to be vital to some of the players that Mark perhaps has signed or will sign in terms of passing on those things? You know, I mean, you know, you've been around many leagues and achieved many, many things. Do you think that's going to be beneficial to the rest of the roster as the season goes ahead?
Yeah, I think so. You know, I think I can really come in and, you know, try and help as best as I can, help the young guys, you know, lead by example and be the first one on the ice every day. And, you know, really do everything that I can to, you know, to show them what I've learned and also, you know, be a good teammate and do my best to try and help the boys win every night. So.
And I was reading in your press release that you've played alongside a number of Stars players in the past. I think we've got players like Finney Scarsella in there, Doug Clarkson, Riley Wetmore, many different players. Is there any in particular you've touched base about your upcoming time in the Dundee Stars jersey?
Yeah, I know Riley Wetmore quite well, and he's such a good person. We've kept in touch over the years, and you know, it's interesting because the longer you play hockey, you know, the more incredible people you meet. It's such a small community, and you know, it's been great. Riley is a great guy. I've reached out to him in the past and stuff. And it's so great, the relationships that you build over the seasons. You know, you come away with some really close friends that you talk to for the rest of your life. And that's another beautiful part of this lovely game.
I suppose one other question just to squeeze in with you is around that off-ice stuff as well, because I know at your time at Cardiff Devils, the fans there, the organization praised you for your off-ice, I suppose, involvement in the community stuff and engagement with fans. And that's a big thing at Dundee Stars. Is that something you're looking forward to continuing here as well?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I think the fans and the community are the most important. So, you know, I've started a hockey business, developing skills and stuff here in Canada. I do that in the summertime, helping kids learn hockey and try and play the game the best that I can. So if that's possible, you know, I'd love to continue doing that in Dundee and helping the youth, being involved in the community. It's so important. So that's a part of hockey that I also really enjoy, is giving back and trying to also grow the game of hockey. So.
And I would normally ask you how you're going to prepare for the season, but I know you've given me a guided tour. I'm sure you can give the fans it as well. But this is where you're training today, right? In your friend's gym, I believe.
Yeah, this is my friend Charlie Soro. He plays in the Del 2 in Ravensburg. And we've been training together here for 3 or 4 years now. So we'll definitely be prepared this season physically and mentally. And we have a lot of fun in here. You know, we get the music going and, you know, get the sweat going, and it's awesome.
Yeah. What's some of the tunes that you're going to be playing there today, Josh, while you're working out? Give the fans
everything. Yeah, we're going to do today. We're going to do a little total body workout today, and we're going to hit the legs. We're going to hit the bench, you know, basically everything. And then maybe a little tennis afterwards to work the cardio, because it's so good for your reaction time and everything. It's just, yeah, it's really good. So,
yeah, listen, final message for the Stars fans, Josh, before I let you go away and get your workout done. Have you got something to say to them before we sign off on this one?
Hey, for Dundee fans, it's Josh Britton here. Can't wait to meet you all. I'm really excited for an incredible season. It's going to be a lot of fun. Can't wait to meet you all, and I look forward to seeing you all soon.
Josh, thanks very much for catching up with us. Can't wait to see you in a Stars jersey, and we appreciate it. Enjoy the workout.
Swanee, thank you so much, man. Look forward to meeting you, and we'll see you soon.